today, guys, going back to round one on the lower side of the bracket to see Team Omega CLS versus Like a Sir. Team Omega CLS consists of Simers as Japan, Liam as Finland, and on the allies we have Grey Goose as British Commonwealth and Volta as USA. I think both of these teams are from the USA region, if I'm not mistaken. Simers, a long-time competitive community member. He's got an assault squad. He's going to be one of the guys to watch in this match. And on the other end, we have Liam going an elite Jaeger marksman squad going to the Northern West. And he's going to meet a Volta who's sending a Ranger squad. He split the Ranger squad into two, though, I believe. Most of them going to the center and only a few going to meet the Jaegers. Not very good to split them up in a shootout engagement. The Finnish marksmen aren't... Ooh, they're finally firing. And should pick up at least one kill and gets one. A nice pickup, which will affect the start quite well. But Grey Goose coming in onto the southern side on a post so far. Simon's sending a few guys to the left of the center. But he's going to get totally shot up with the combined forces of Volta and Grey Goose. Simon's in the center trying to grenade in. So much shootout. Looks like they've now drawn the lines between the sides of the center. Both of them having some troops on each end. The other side looks a bit stronger, I think, in terms of the shootout capability. So still a bit of pressure. Volta with some sandbags. Elite marksman should be able to put them away eventually. Going to finish him off maybe with a grenade. Some more sandbags from Liam. Smolly. So, this is the second game, guys. I don't know if I mentioned that. First game went Omega CLS's way. And just going to jump in straight to the second to save a bit of time. But also to give Like a Sir a bit of a cast. Volta, one guy on the right on his own. Simus has managed to micro grenade his way into that point. Grey Goose trying to come in again, does not succeed. So center is still no one's flag at the stage. I'm not sure who's it going to. It's quite even still, a few guys on each end. Some reinforcements of a regular squad by Volta. And this guy is going to try and throw a sneaky grenade somehow. Don't think he will. And here is a BA-20 buy from Liam. The Finnish rush vehicle. A Type 92 type rush, like Japan. Forces the Ranger to go into the buildings. Excuse me. And now flanking the sandbag line, the potential sandbag line from Volta. And has pushed away the regular squad as well. MG is not moving. Hits the wooden stack. Unfortunately doesn't have the weight to get rid of it. It doesn't kill too much, just a bit of scaring tactics there, and smoking tactics as well from the allied team. So that now allows the center to go to the axis. VA-20 still not counterable, nothing's coming to counter it now. Here comes the half-track, decent buy versus the VA-20 and can counter it. 80 infantry from Grey Goose. Left-hand side. Simus now is meeting an attack from Grey Goose, assault squad. The Anzacs plus some reservists, some New Zealander reservists. Let's have a check out of the skins. And the Anzacs coming in. Simon's not sure he's going to hold quite even at the moment. Guess it'll depend who will micro that grenade over. Half track now pushing to the right of the center, or left of the center. Looks like there's nothing, no counters from the Axis at this stage. Gonna hover over closer and now pick off everyone bit by bit. Simon's with an assault squad, the full assault squad, and I think that could be Volta's target right now. There's so many juicy hits, but Simon's with a grenade, perhaps a DC'd one. Gonna get inside the hard track, doesn't, and misses, unfortunately. Though he has decrewed one of the guys, the driver, and this marksman Jaeger is actually quite deadly close range. So lucky Volta has decided to not fight that. Go back, wait for reinforcements, a wise thing to do. And we'll get that point back. Some nice maneuvering by Tilaika Sir. And counter not seen yet. Some maximum indirect fire. One special point from Liam. La T-80 rifle counter from Liam as well. For this vehicle. Very slow to counter. And at the same time we've got the other sides. Oh wow, it's a 4-cap from the southern to east all the way to this point over here. Going to the Axis forces of Like a Sir. British Commonwealth Stuart coming out, the cheap one. I think it's a bit stronger than the normal Stuart. RT-80 rifle. Direct fire, not going to do too much at this stage. It's meant to fire from afar and really just pin down troops. So you can fire from ridiculous angles. Oh, it actually killed something. Nice. Okay, never mind. It actually did some damage. I was going to say it doesn't actually kill anything. I suppose it will eventually. Now, doing okay, shooting over the hills. Potentially could have been put back in a more safer position because the arc of this gun is massive. Lati AT Rifle going to be perched up on this hill and will be able to take out any light vehicles. And wow, a nice push as well. Well, not quite yet. Liam still holding strong in the center of that flag. They've got the weight of the cap being closer to the center. But some more troops from Volta with an assault squad could force maybe a 5 cap if they get the center. Maxim gun still trying to pin down the units. Struggling to hit the MG though. MG's not going to be pinned down. Seems like it's trying to go for the SMG guy. Liam's got the half-track MG onto Sandbag. And going toe-to-toe with this lone BAR guy. Nice grenade from Simons. Takes out a few. Grey Goose coming in for the flank. The rest of his troops. And they should hold, I think, with the 50 cal. Even more coming over here from Volta. Maxim still pounding away in the center. Not doing too much. They've managed to cap the western northern middle point. Lati AT rifle repositioning into the river. Wow, look at the low profile of this unit. The guys manning it aren't even breathing. They're just, they should go join some Guinness World Records or something. This guy can breathe underwater. I don't know what they drink in Finland. They obviously breed them quite well. They've made Mr. Pringles, one of the top players in this community for a long time. That's probably what's, why he can breathe underwater. Same as this guy, breathes underwater. So holding on, Omega CLS, definitely the favorites for this matchup. These Volta and Grey Goose are, I guess, very experienced players, but not competitive-wise. I believe this is one of their first tournaments they've entered. Simons and Liam have appeared in many tournaments in the past, though a bit out of form. Especially Simons used to be a lot better than he is, Liam as well. And that's a crash, guys. God damn it. Alright, guys, I've just reloaded the game, waited 7 minutes, and I think I'm back up to where it crashed. So Stuart is doing some good work from Lacassur on the southern point. Simons has some paratroopers into position though, should be able to outshoot all the infantry attacking it. It'd be fine actually. There's only 2 assault squad guys left. That Stuart is not supported too well, but is doing decent damage with the HE shell. Knocking down the barrels. Paratroopers are... took out the MG guy. Center also being assaulted by Grey Goose at the same time with the assault squad. Has the numbers on Simons on this one and should be able to take it. And on this side, looks like the same thing's happening with Volta, just getting the numbers on the axis at this stage. Chihi out from Simons, good counter for the Stuart. She's able to make a play, easy shot right now. It hits the really front ankle and doesn't do a thing. And that Stuart's running away, it's got the side turned, it's crew injured, next one should put it away, easy side trip from Simons, staying still, boom. Nice shot, Simons, got your money shot right there. And a lovely explosion for you and everyone. So the center is going to nobody. Volta has a sneaky guy, not brave enough to venture in. Both have good, have some sandbag lines on the sides. Pinged Bofors right there. Anything to take it out? Perhaps the Lati AT rifle. It's moving up to the higher ground now. And I think it will try to go for it. Not sure if it's in range though. Can't actually tell. I'm watching Simons. I don't dare to change the player. It'll probably screw up the replay. But I think Liam's taking a shot. No, he's not. Volta's now firing with his Bofors. I think Liam can't for some reason. It's on hold fire, so maybe he's just not DCing it. Perhaps he can. Southern Eastern seems like Simons is holding okay. There's another vehicle coming. Let's just switch over there. Looks like Liam's not doing much. He's going to move forward, it seems. Let's check out this engagement. It's just the truck. Oh no, it's the 3-pointer AA truck. It's not a 40mm. This is probably not a good buy for the Chihi on this map, but he is, I guess, sending it to the better part of the map with a lot of buildings to hide behind. He's just waiting for it. He's got a decent 40mm, reloads fires very, very fast. Fast rate of fire. But needs to get pretty close or get a side shot on the Chi. He's gonna try and make a move now. Chi for a shot pass. Oh! Misses. Another potential shot chance. Oop, ducks away from the hill. Chi trying to track it. Grey Goose is another shot chance behind the hay ball. He's gonna move a bit more and he's into safety for now. Getting some line of sight in front. Very nice of him. Center mid not being capped yet, so it's very even. 28-10. A lead from Omega CLS, but constant flag changes and all the flags seem to be takeable, really. None of the flags are held down that strongly. Potentially this one now is, with a lot of infantry. So many. But let's see this move by Grey Goose. He wants to play a player, 50-50 play, and force the Chinyu to back away. And now the Chinyu is going to... Now the great 37mm half-track is going to try to flank the guys in this flag. Simons has a guy over here, which is going to take it. Oh, he's going to take a play. And then gets ready for it. Oh, it's tracked it. No, it hasn't tracked the HE. He only hits the turret, doesn't destroy the engine. So it's safe. Chihi backing away once again. Some more infantry coming up. Only two guys for line of sight at this stage. But lucky there isn't anyone sneaking up on him, really. He was one guy over here in DC. Oh, no, he's not going to make it, so he's safe for now. It's been quite cheeky. Is this coming out? What did he come out for? Is this one hit? Now he's going back into the cover. He's only got, I dare say, two guys in there now, and it's going to be hard to drive and shoot. I believe he probably can't drive and shoot at the same time now. Or maybe he can. He's going to try it again. What is he doing? It's too far. Yeah, he wants to shoot down here. I don't know. Yeah, he's going to try that. That's right. But Simons now pressuring. He's got infantry going. Oh, and it's forced to back away. He's been tracked by the Chihi. And now Simons is going to put away with the AP grenade over the front. Doesn't matter. Chihi has taken it out. And this AP grenade should take it out. Nope. Just takes out the crew. AP grenade, finish it off. Boom. Decent move from Simons. Maybe just a risky move from Grey Goose right there. A bit too risky. Wasn't really needed at that stage. Chihi now moving up and should now secure this point. And going back to Omega CLS. Liam with the Lightning Squad soldier there. Bright orange backpack. Holding his gun to the right side. Capping this point. Sherman Croc made an appearance by Volta on this side and has secured the flag. Now moving off to the center perhaps. And also 76 M4A1 Sherman. Take a flank shot of the Chinyu. Chinyu backs away. Oh no, it's gonna go forward. Yep, it's going to go behind the building, maybe for a 50-50 play. No, it's deciding to walk, waltz away into safety, try to reverse in further and further away to get away. Looks like he should be okay. Excuse me. There's the Croc. Crocs are going back on this point, and should push off, He's got that 76mm support gun, but nothing for that Croc at this stage. But the Panzerstreck's coming in. I think he's been spotted, though. Definitely been spotted from a long time. Nothing for it, though, really. There's no infantry around. That Panzerstreck didn't even get there. It's like a long time coming. Croc's trying to outrun it. He's still trying to outrun it. That Panzerstreck's got the longest walk ever. And that AT shell slowed down the Croc for a bit. Oh, a little bit of health left. That Panzerstreck maybe doesn't matter. There's 80 grenades happening. Oh, that's an 80 grenade. Oh, it doesn't... look at that, that's hilarious. That Panzerstreck guy is still alive. Now back onto that hill and going down to safety. Wow, that was a long run for that Croc. 76 Brother at the top to help it out as well. But side shot from the Chihi. Nice. Wow, Simon's a cheeky pop shot. Takes the Croc with its pants down, which was doing a strange marathon across the map. Didn't do too much damage, in fact, didn't take out... Well, took out quite a few, I guess. Put some guys behind the sandbags, but... Still open. No point sticking to anyone yet, as it's a neutral flag. The last final flag to cap, to make it a majority, is decapped. Right over there. OT-130 tank flamethrower. Guess it's an okay buy at this stage, as there is no sort of AT weaponry from the allies on the right flag, and this is going to do a lot of damage. Simon's encountering some attack commandos from Vegas. Still our rivals. I'm gonna win in the shootout versus these lowly recruits, most definitely. It's not all in a very good firing position, it seems. Few in the back. Oh no, this is the KR. Sorry, the King's African Rifle. So not as good as the commandos. They got the Lee Enfields. Oh, Mateo's got the guy with the Webley. This officer. Oh, it's taking out one. Oh no, it doesn't take out two. Just sitting up there, not doing much. He's been sitting back there. And he's the OT. It looks like it's done a bit of work. But and it's the flame himself, unfortunately, Liam. Bit of a silly guy. Oh, some shrapnel flying there. Will it come down? No, went to space. So, elite, not so an elite marksman. Rifleman. Cap that flag. Stuart out from Liam. Sorry, from Volta. So, Volta, the USA Stuart. 76 artillery doing nice work from Liam. Finish off that last guy, quite accurate, but not that accurate. Stuart now moving in, can actually threaten the 76. Oh, did it actually hit? It probably hit, but didn't do damage it. Trying to AP shell it. Oh, AP shell didn't do much again. It's going to try to take it out, in fact. Looks like it's going to try to run away. It's been decrewed by the AP shell, and maybe the AP shell can put away. But Simers may have something to say about that. Yokane Minotaya. That's the left soldier, Panzer Shrek. The turret's not turned the right way. Easy put away for Simers. Bam. Having a good game right now, Mr. Simmers or Simers. Simmering. Simers is simmering today. Yep. That is simmering indeed. Nice flank as well. Oh, not really, but they did okay, I guess. Have flanked a lot of the Axis troops, and nice one by Volta with the half track finish to finish them off. Airborne will cap that point, but still struggling to get the majority. Omega is slowly, I guess, ticking up. It's a very action-packed game, full of swings, but Omega seems to have always held on to majority longer. 46-12. Chi for 50-50 play, 76 caught napping. Simers can take a peekaboo shot and does so. Simers winning the engagements with worse off tanks, but Chihi too confident at that stage. Probably wanted to just finish it off from the side so it wouldn't get repaired. But definitely a bit of a risky play. Doesn't really matter. I'm sure Simers has a lot of money to spare now as he hasn't had to buy a tank since that Chihi. Here we go. Here is the Hugger. Coming in. Let's take a look. Hugger moving. Nice HG shell damage, fast reloading. As on the right side, 76mm. Panning away. On the right side, it's a tawny detachment from Liam. Should be a force to be reckoned with now. It comes with lots of elite troops and snipers. I think this is the time the Axis will come back quite easily now. The tawny is out. 47, 48, 57 from Grey Goose. Probably take out that Hargo. Red infantry wise, just way too much now. And nothing much coming. And we've got the elite tawny squad now on the western north. Should be able to hold quite easily. I think this is definitely Omega CLS's game. So I'm just going to call it, to be honest. It's 5 cap. And throughout the whole map, nothing of worth coming from the allies that can attack. So Omega CLS will push forward to face off. I'm not sure actually, is it European Gentlemen or another team? We'll see. Request played by Omega CLS. See them through. I can't wait for the future matches to come. Don't have much to say, sorry. Just letting you know also, Jessica's working on a mod. I guess a modified version of World at Warp, making it more polished, improving the icons, all the icons, improving all the missing, I guess, localization, missing things everywhere, improving the special points. Some of them were a bit rushed, I guess, because I did it as quick as possible in the time I had. Get things up and running is gonna, yeah, basically overhaul World at Warp, make it World at Warp 2.0. Or I could even call it, I think it's Norman is involved too. We're getting a lot of his models and you can call it special unique features such as the trenches, tank ditches, all that stuff which he has in his mod, which can be ported to a World at War. So it could be called Valor Multiplayer Competitive Mod, which I don't mind. I don't care if it's called World at War or whatever. I just want it to be played and be a better game. So good on those guys. Hopefully it comes through. Though not holding my breath. Just gonna say, just so it gives just a bit of motivation that he's done a few things like this before, but never sees it to the end. But let's see how it goes this time. Sorry guys, just seeing this game through is just total domination now. I don't think they can come back. This is action of the M2A4. No chance. This is the Cheeto can't really hit it. Simon's been quite scared though. And put away. Boom. And Tech Destroyer, 6-pounder, can do it. Oh, what the? Oh, the MD's wrecking the turret. That's hilarious. Cheeto puts it away though. How weak is that turret? Getting killed by a light machine gunner. Oh no, maybe not light, it's an MG port, DP27. And there you go, nice game from Team Omega CLS. They go through, and Volta and Gregus in the lower bracket now. Like a sir.